If you're wondering what I'm wearing right now, I'm wearing my Oakley 3D Special Edition Tron glasses. This works well since this month I will be reviewing three 3D films. But first, let's talk about 3D technology for a second, shall we? So what is a 3D or an S3D film? A 3D or stereoscopic three-dimensional film is a motion picture that enhances illusion and depth perception. This is done when an image is seen from two different perspectives simultaneously. The usage of special projection hardware and/or eyewear provides a more three-dimensional image when the two images are merged into one. Now, 3D films have been around since even before the 1950s. However, due to the high cost of the hardware and the length of time the processes take, 3D films were extremely rare. Over the years, popularity of 3D films have had its ups and downs. 3D motion pictures have been made through many different methods. Now, I won't bore you with all the many details or the list of all these processes, so I'll stick with the two most well-known processes. The first up is the anaglyph. This type of 3D process uses the most famous 3D glasses that have been used and in some ways are still used today, though sparingly. Anaglyph glasses use one red and one cyan filter system, one for each eye. These colors match up to the colored outlines of the two images on the screen. When wearing these two glasses, your eyes are supposed to capture the two images together and merge them into one image, thus creating a 3D image. Although the colors get annoying and kind of screw with the clarity of the film, that's how 3D movies were done back in the day. The more modern 3D glasses that are used today are polarized 3D glasses. Instead of using colors, they use two images superimposed onto differing polarizing filters. The 3D glasses then filter the polarization differently in each eye and allow the viewer to see the same exact scene in both their eyes, but from different perspectives. Now, for the purposes of the reviews this month, we'll focus on these two processes, especially the polarized 3D films that come from Real-D and IMAX, just to name a few. Now, over the past decade, 3D movies have been picking up speed and popularity. It's getting to a point that televisions and now video games are being made with 3D technology. What's next? 3D technology that doesn't require any type of corrective lenses? Okay, will somebody please tell technology to slow the hell down? We need to have time to enjoy the stuff we have rather than buying new technology and throwing it away in a couple months in place of something new. Jeez. Now, 3D movies have now become a growing trend again, but at an even faster rate than ever before. When 3D is incorporated into films properly, it can enhance the viewing experience. When it's not done well, it becomes a big waste of money. With that in mind, let's talk about Tron Legacy. Now, if you haven't heard of the original 1982 Tron movie, here's a little rundown. A hacker by the name of Kevin Flynn, played by Jeff Bridges, gets pulled into a world of a computer and is forced to participate in games similar to what the gladiators did back in ancient Rome. With the help of a security program named Tron, played by Bruce Boxleitner, Flynn is going to fight in any way possible to defeat the evil Master Control Program and escape this digital world. Now, this movie was very revolutionary for its time and used a lot of digital computerized special effects. It was fun and unique and an interesting movie, especially for all the cyber geeks out there. It has aged quite a bit, but with an open and relaxed mind, you might learn to appreciate it. forward to the year 2010, or roughly by the movie's count, about 27 years later. Sam Flynn, played by Garrett Hedlund, is the son of Kevin Flynn. He receives a signal sent from his father's old arcade after his father's disappearance over 20 years ago. After investigating the signal, he's pulled into an evolved version of the digital world from the first movie. Now both Sam and his father, along with Cora, played by Olivia Wilde, must escape the cyber world and stop Kevin's alter ego Clue from bringing a digital army into our world. Now, overall, I did enjoy this movie, and actually, I didn't even have any high expectations going into it. It's been over, 27, 28 years between the films, and with the change in the focus of the storyline and the technology in movies, I just wanted to sit back and enjoy the movie. And I did. It would help if you've at least experienced and seen the first movie, if not liked it, but overall, the movie was pretty good on its own and did at least enough backstory to introduce a few things to you. Of course, the storyline seemed to draw more from movie cliches, which made the movie a bit predictable. As for the 3D section, I would like to start off by saying most 3D movies don't always work as well as expected. The parts in the movie that were in 3D were the Disney logo at the beginning and everything happening in the digital world. However, most 3D movies back in the day focused on making you a part of the movie, with things popping out from the screen or flying at you, or even imaginary interaction between the audience and the characters or the environment. However, in this movie, the 3D seemed to be more focused on making the world more realistic, as though you were put in the eyes of the characters themselves. Although the movie did fit its role, and there were a few scenes where things would fly out at you and engage you, the 3D scenes weren't engaging enough, and there weren't enough 3D scenes where things seemed to draw you into the movie that made me feel as though the 3D made a major difference in the experience of the movie. Now, if you like the first movie, or computer and digital movies, technological movies, or even unique, different created worlds, this movie is worth checking out. Disney's Tron Legacy. Well, that's the first film in 3D month. Until next time,